Let's face it, despite pretty much everyone in IT's best efforts, Windows XP just refuses to die. Even Microsoft backed down on their official drop of support for it to release a security patch last year. There's one catch though. Not many new XP computers are being added into the world, especially since less hardware actually supports the OS. Thankfully, I come to you today with a solution. A solution that not only allows you to run Windows XP, or really any version of Windows, on nearly any modestly powerful computer, but a solution that also allows you to carry your XP machine in your pocket and share the joys of the 16-year-old operating system anywhere, from your own machines, to school computers, to pretty much anything with a USB port and an x86 processor. Now first, this might seem like a pretty simple task. Just like how I installed Windows from a flash drive a few videos ago, I should be able to install Windows onto a flash drive and boot from it. No dice. The Windows XP installer couldn't access the flash drive despite recognizing it, and even copying a successfully installed image onto the drive resulted in a blue screen since XP by default lacks support, and more importantly the drivers, for modern hardware, as many standards like SATA actually came out after XP did. A reasonable countermeasure for this driver conflict is to use a virtual machine. Programs like VirtualBox can sit in between Windows XP and the actual hardware, emulate the old stuff, and make everything work smoothly. Plus, by creating a virtual machine, the same install of XP can run on several different computers without having to install new drivers. There's still one catch though, and that is that VirtualBox needs to be installed onto the system to run, which requires administrator access, pretty effectively limiting the computers you can run XP on in the wild. Even portable versions of VirtualBox meant to be run off a flash drive still carry this issue. No, the only way to get around this, that I've found anyhow, is to boot the virtual machine entirely off the flash drive, which I'm about to show you how to do yourself. Now to do this install, you're going to need a few things. Pretty obviously, a flash drive. I use this 32GB one, but you could probably get away with 16GB. 8GB is really pushing it though, and probably won't have enough space for more than an extremely limited install. You'll also need to install VirtualBox on your computer, as well as Win32 Disk Imager, both links in the description. Last but not least, you'll also need the ISOs for both XP and the OS you're going to launch the virtual machine in. I personally used Ubuntu because it supported a lot of the hardware I tested it on, but you can probably get away with other more lightweight Linux distros if system resources are really a concern. As for the XP ISO, I can't provide one myself, though if you have an XP install disk, VirtualBox can load it from your CD drive, or you can search for a Windows XP VirtualBox installation tutorial. Many of them offer the necessary installation files for download, and also offer instructions on how to get them to work in VirtualBox. I'm going to preface this by saying this video isn't intended to be a VirtualBox tutorial, and you should be fairly confident on how to create a virtual machine as well as be able to run a few commands in command prompt, since I won't be going over every little detail. The software is pretty self-explanatory though, and if all else fails, the YouTube tutorials I previously mentioned are pretty helpful. To start, you're going to want to create a drive just a bit smaller than the size of your flash drive. Mine was 29.4GB, so I set the hard disk size to 28GB just to be safe. Then, install Ubuntu, or whatever distro you chose, onto the VM. Once you get to the Ubuntu desktop, you're going to want to install VirtualBox inside your virtual machine. Yes, I know, virtual machine-ception. Trust me, it'll all make sense in the end. You can install VirtualBox by going on the terminal and typing in sudo apt-get install VirtualBox, paying close attention to capitalization, or to be more precise, the lack thereof. Once the terminal says VirtualBox was successfully installed, you should be able to search for it and open it. Now, you can finally create the VM that will run Windows XP. Choose your specs, keeping in mind that XP isn't too demanding, and load in the Windows XP ISO. There are plenty of ways to do this, either by just downloading within the Linux VM, using one of VirtualBox's file sharing features, or by loading the disk onto the drive of the outer VirtualBox window and then accessing it from the inner window. However you work it out, you can now install XP. Follow all the steps on screen, and once you hit the iconic Bliss image, you're done. Of course, there are a few tweaks to make your virtual machine a bit better. First, go up to Devices in the inner VirtualBox window and select Insert Guest Edition CD. This will add drivers to XP that let it work better in VirtualBox, specifically by allowing it to match the native screen resolution. You can also go into View and set the virtual machine to full screen mode so that your XP experience can take full advantage of your display. Finally, after turning off your virtual machine, you can go into Settings, User Interface, and uncheck this box to get rid of that pesky immersion-ruining menu bar at the bottom of the screen. On the Linux side of things, I prefer to auto-hide the launcher sidebar and set the wallpaper to solid black to hide the fact that the drive is booting into a host OS before launching Windows. The last touch is entering this command into the list of startup programs to make the VirtualBox launch automatically on boot up. Note that where mine says Windows XP, you'll have to change yours to whatever name you gave the inner virtual machine. With two OSs installed and all these settings tweaked, you can finally power down the outer virtual machine and prepare to write the whole thing to a flash drive. First off, you'll need to find the virtual hard disk for the outer Linux VM. Usually, this can be found in your users folder under VirtualBox VMs. If you use default settings, the file should end in .vdi. Once you've located the file, you'll need to open Command Prompt and navigate to the path shown on the screen. Then, run this command, entering in the path for the VDI file that you found earlier into the source path, and the same path for the destination, but with the file extension .img instead of VDI. Watch out though, you'll need at least as much space on your disk as was the size of your virtual hard disk. For example, in my case, since I set mine to 28GB, the resultant file I'm making will also take up 28GB. This might take a while, so be patient if it looks like the program isn't making any progress. Finally, once you've made the IMG file, open Win32 Disk Imager, and, being extra careful to select the right flash drive since this will wipe any data written on it beforehand, write the IMG file to the drive. For me, this took well over an hour, so be patient. If all goes well, you should have a flash drive that lets you boot, indirectly, into Windows XP. Alright, that was a lot of work, but now comes the fun part, testing the flash drive. Plug the flash drive into a computer, pretty much any PC made after 2005 should work, and power it on. In some cases, the screen should turn purple for a little bit while Ubuntu loads up. In that case, you're all good, and the flash drive is already being booted from. If that's not the case, and the computer is just starting up into Windows like normal, restart it and look for any keys on the first screen that refer to BIOS or boot settings. If you don't see anything, you may have to look them up online for your specific model. Anyways, either by setting the flash drive to the top of your computer's boot order, or just by simply selecting it to boot from, you should be able to launch right into Ubuntu from your flash drive, and from there, right into XP. And there you have it, a whole lot of work getting everything set up, but in the end, you now have a flash drive that runs Windows XP on almost any computer. Whether you want to use it for nostalgic purposes, as a prank, or even just to run Bonzi Buddy wherever you go, the choice is yours. I should also mention that this works for more than just XP. Pretty much any version of Windows can be installed in VirtualBox, meaning that if you want a Windows 95 flash drive, or a Windows 7 flash drive, or something else entirely, you can do that too. I'm not going to act like this is the most efficient method to get this to work, and I'd welcome any suggestions for improving this process in the comments, but so far, this hodgepodge method of installing a virtual machine inside of a virtual machine and then imaging the entire thing over to a flash drive seems to work pretty well. I've been able to successfully boot into XP from every computer that I tested it on, from fairly recent high-end machines all the way down to a crummy laptop from a decade ago. Have fun, and enjoy doing your part in depriving Windows XP of any sort of peaceful death.